right. Well, thank you, everyone. Presto Geosystems webcast learning series today. Our webinar will focus on GEOWEB solution for rail ballast support. I'd like to thank you for taking time out of your busy schedules to attend. A little about myself. I've been the chief design engineer with Presto for the last 12 years. Prior to joining Presto, I was an engineering consultant for 20 years, focusing on all different types of civil and geotechnical projects. I'm an active member on REMA Committee 1, Roadway Ballast, specifically Subcommittee on Geosynthetics, and REMA Committee 5, which is track, and subcommittee on crossings. As you are aware, REMA Committee has set the design standards used for all rail applications. GEOWEB is included in the REMA manual under Chapter 1, Section 10, Geosynthetics. Quickly, here are the things I hope you get out of today's presentation. Understand the benefits of GEOWEB stabilized ballast. Learn about the GEOWEB system, how flexible and versatile the system is, and know that the system can work on all applicate rail applications through subgrade pressure and ballast movement. If you have any questions, please type in the chat window during the presentation, and we can address them at the end. Presto worked with the Army Corps of Engineers to develop geocell technology in the late 70s, and we continue to be the leader in innovation. We offer more than just a product. We offer a complete solution. We work with our customers from the initial concept phase through construction to support a successful project. We have a worldwide distribution network, experience not only in geos technology, but other geosynthetics as well. Our assistance does not stop when the product leaves our door. Now I guess we'll move on and discuss the GEOWEB system. The GEOWEB system consists of two main attributes. The first is the cell size. The cells come in three different diameters, 8.5, 10.5, and 18 inches. The cell wall heights include 3, 4, 6, 8, and 12 inches. The actual cell size and height depend on site-specific project details and site conditions. Presto provides a free evaluation, including calculations, cross-section specifications for all of our applications, no matter the size. The ultrasonically welded seam, where all the connecting points are located, is very important to the function of a geocell. The stronger the seam strength, the better performance of the geocell, period. A strong seam allows for better lifetime performance. GEOWEB is produced using a high quality, virgin high density polyethylene resin for consistently strong welds at the seams, while also maintaining semi-rigid ductile properties, high stress crack resistance, overall toughness, and long-term durability. GEOWEB geocells do not use fillers or exotic polymer alloy blends, which can ultimately reduce weld strength that are offered to some competing products. To avoid weld failures and the damaging effects of differential settlement, uniformity and performance across all elements of a geocell system is much more important than stiffness alone. Here you can see a typical GEOWEB panel. It comes tri-folded on a pallet. Each section has a nominal width of 8.5 feet, with lengths up to 52 feet depending on the cell size. The panels are very, very flexible, and as you can see in the picture, they open like an accordion. They ship very efficiently. Typically, here's a section. If it's a 30 VR standard material, ships about 12 sections on a pallet and up to almost over a little over 100,000 square feet on a typical truck. In order for a geocell system to perform uniformly, it is critical that both the factory welded junctions and field joint junctions that connect individual panels perform at a level that is commensurate with that of the cell walls. Three primary elements of any geocell system: cell walls, internal junctions, and field connectors must perform uniformly as a complete system. Therefore, an incremental improvement in one characteristic, for example, cell stiffness, is only valuable if a complementary improvement has been made in the other components. GEOWEB, as stated before, GEOWEB is manufactured using a proprietary blend of high quality, virgin, high density polyethylene. Our proprietary formula has stood the test of time for more than 40 years and contains no fillers, polymer alloys, or exotic other polymer alloys. For most typical sites, GEOWEB retained its durability for greater than 50 years, with lab testing indicating 149 years without degradation, even at full exposure to the sun. We stand behind our numbers so you can deliver certainty in the solution as you build with materials you can trust. The GEOWEB system components are all supporting pieces that help the GEOWEB protect the surface and subbase layers, and also ensure relatively uniform performance of their interconnected system, thereby protecting against the damaging effects of differential settlement in response to an applied load. Presto GEOWEB is equipped with numerous design and construction components that increase strength and speed of installation. For load support applications, the AttraKey is the major component for a completely integrated system. AttraKeys connect GEOWEB panels into a single system. The keys speed installation and are made out of plastic and will last the lifetime of the project. AttraKeys ensure that the panels will not separate and that the GEOWEB system will not fail under anticipated loads. The specific engineering values of the AttraKey will ensure the system holds up to loading over time without the corrosion seen in staples or the failure of underperforming zip tie systems. The purpose of cellular confinement is very simple. It's to stabilize the movement of soils, whether that's horizontally or vertically. It is an engineered system integrating multiple geosynthetics with the best method of confinement and subgrade stress reduction. Although today's discussion will focus mostly on rail ballast support, other applications include load support, slope and shadow protection, and GEOWEB walls. We can actually do gravity walls and reinforced MSC walls. GEOWEB 3 confinement works this way. When a vertical load is applied, the active earth pressure in the loaded cell pushes back against the passive earth pressure in the adjacent cell to form a stable system. So each cell helps support the ones around it. The GEOWEB cell walls also transfer hoop stress, which is important in keeping the system intact and creates what is known as the mattress effect. The strength of the seams around each cell, the material stiffness, the individual strips, and the connection mechanism between the panels are all important factors in determining how the GeoCell system can improve site condition. Strong seams, semi-ductile resin properties, and integrated connections are critical to uniform performance of the installed system over the life of the project. In a load support scenario, vertical deformation can only occur with the compaction or through lateral movement. By spreading out the load in the classic approach, one can reduce compaction of near surface soils, but only with cellular confinement can you assure no lateral shifting and running. Here you can see stress on the subgrade with the unsupported subgrade on the left and GEOWEB reinforcement on the right. Notice how there's a complete elimination of the high stresses at the surface with GEOWEB reinforcement. Stresses are reduced and distributed over a wide area, which we call the mattress effect. This mattress effect reduces stress, reaching the subgrade, and leads to a significant decrease in deflection and rutting. The second attribute is the infill, an important benefit of the GEOWEB system that even a low quality aggregate, such as sand or salvage material, can be used to infill the cells. Using salvage materials, low quality aggregate or sand can save a significant amount of money on material and hauling costs. We can also eliminate fines when desired, since the cells provide the confinement and aid compaction of the cohesion of the soils. Without fines, you can significantly improve drainage and let the water flow freely through the system, preventing pore pressure buildup and potential global failure. The ability to use sands and low-quality aggregates really sets you apart from GeoGrids and GeoTextiles. Those products require high-quality materials with high friction angles to achieve optimum performance. With the GeoWeb system, low friction angle materials are just fine. The GeoWeb panels achieve their potential even with these poor materials, which can be a significant cost savings. Here you can see the impressive load score benefits. This is an 80,000-pound dump truck on a partially filled GeoWeb panel over a soft subgrade. You can see how the cells push back against each other to support the load, and only the adjacent cell needs to be filled for support. A great benefit to using the GEOWEB system is that you don't need to have every cell completely filled before the road or the ballast layer is subject and can be used as a haul road. You can reduce construction time and materials with this approach. Just a little bit to talk on some past and some research we did with the GEOWEB system. First rail research we completed was in the early 1990s at the TTI Center outside of Pueblo, Colorado. TTCI provides research and testing for all aspects of railroad and associated equipment. The facility has approximately 50 miles of track. The research we are going to look at today was conducted on the fast high tonnage loop. GEOWEB was installed in section 29, which is a 700-foot section on the high tonnage loop. This loop is continuously loaded except when new materials and ideas are tested. This study was 2.5 years and was compared to a control section. Mississippi mud was imported to the site The soil is a high plasticate or a high plasticity clay, having CBR less than 3% with a 30% moisture content. Without the GEOWEB system, concentrated loads and high pressure in the ballast squeeze the clay outward and upward, resulting in an unacceptable track profile and contaminated ballast. Sure, we have all seen this situation quite frequently. Without GEOWEB confinement, the control section required tamping every 1 million gross tons of the loading under a 315 kip car. However, with the GEOWEB system, the load was distributed over a larger area, which significantly reduced ballast pressure, which can lead to stiffening of the sub-ballast layer and dissipated load to the subgrade. Acceptable track gravity was maintained throughout the 2.5-year test, and over 206 million gross tons were applied with a 315 kip car. Here you can see the impressive results. Without GEOWEB, tamping was required on an average of every 1 million gross tons to stay within the track profile limit of 0.5 centimeters. With GEOWEB and over 206 million gross tons of loading, the vertical track alignment never exceeded 0.7 centimeters or 30% of the allowable, and the cross-track alignment never exceeded 0.5 centimeters during the 2.5-year test period. To ensure that testing would capture the worst case scenario for that clay subgrade, they actually brought in some fire hoses and dumped 100,000 gallons of water to simulate two 500-year rainfall events, saturating the expansive clay. No appreciable effect was measured. The test section is actually still in place and operating fine. Based on the success of the TTCI testing, we wanted to use recent technology to confirm the stabilization benefits of GEOWEB. The testing program of GeoCell reinforced ballast over a week subgrade was performed at the University of Kansas. In addition to the University of Kansas research, Oregon State University performed state-of-the-art three-dimensional finite element modeling to analyze the reinforcing benefits of GEOWEB in rail application. Each test was instrumented with earth pressure cells and smart rocks. Earth pressure cells were used to measure the vertical stresses and displacements at the interface between ballast and subgrade. Each smart rock included a motion and vibration sensor that could record the rotation and movement of the ballast. The research was conducted under the direction of Dr. Yi Han, who has been researching geocells for over 20 years. Ben Lashinsky from Oregon State, who did his PhD research and thesis on geocells, conducted the finite element analysis. And Dr. Hai Hung from Penn State provided the smart rock technology. Sorry, computer's a little slower. The testing consisted of 300 kip car, the equivalent 37.5 kip wheel loads, 75 mile hour speed, 136 pound rail, and wood ties. We varied the subgrade from 0.5 to 5% CBR. We did a total of 8 tests, 3 control sections, and 5 GEOWEB support tests with a minimum of 1,000 passes. To evaluate ballast rotation and movement under the cyclical loads, smart rocks were added to the ballast layer halfway between the bottom of the tie and the GEOWEB panels, along the inside of the GEOWEB panels. This was an 8-inch ballast layer, so these smart rocks were placed 4 inches below the tie and 4 inches above the GEOWEB layer. And here you can see the smart rocks inside of the GEOWEB. This slide shows angular velocity, which is how fast a particle rotates. The two graphs on the left show where the smart rocks are placed in the middle of the ballast layer between the bottom of the tie and the GEOWEB panel. So this one was placed 4 inches below it, seated, and 4 inches above. The two graphs on the right are smart rocks placed inside of the GEOWEB panels. You can see the difference between the control section and GEOWEB stabilized section. It's very interesting that stabilization not only controls ballast movement inside of the geocells, but also see the graphs on the left, which show how stabilization controls rotation of the unconfined ballast layer between the tie and the GEOWEB panels. Since GEOWEB significantly reduces the stress, decreases the stress reaching the subgrade layer, the ballast rotation between the bottom of the tie and the top of the GEOWEB panel is significantly decreased. Of course, we expect confinement of the smart rock inside the GEOWEB panel would not rotate that much, but the ability to control rotation below the tie is significant. And here you can see this section right here is 4 inches below the tie, 4 inches above the GEOWEB. This slide shows angular acceleration, which is just how fast the particle moves when subjected to cyclical loads. Just like in the previous slide, you can see the GEOWEB stabilization controls movement in the cells and also below the tie. The two graphs on the left show the smart rocks were placed 4 inches below the tie and inside of the GEOWEB panels. The two graphs on the left are inside the GEOWEB panels. You can see the difference between the control section and the GEOWEB stabilized section. Very interesting that stabilized section not only controls ballast once again in the cells, but you can also see on the graph on the left how stabilization controls movement of the unconfined ballast layers between the tie and the panel. Once again, here is the 4 inches below the tie and 4 inches above the GEOWEB. The test results clearly show that GEOWEB stabilization significantly reduces the particle rotation and movement, not only in the cells, but below the tie. The results show that stabilization can effectively minimize the movement of ballast particles by providing lateral confinement so that breakage, vertical compression, attrition, and lateral spreading is minimized and performance can be significantly improved. It's significant that GEOWEB can reduce the rotation movement of the ballast below the tie, which will extend the life of the ballast and provide a more stable system. By controlling ballast movement and rotation, this will lead to decreased ballast tamping and reduced maintenance will directly lead to cost savings. We also evaluated the data using state-of-the-art finite element analysis to confirm the reinforcing benefit of GEOWEB stabilization. Finite element analysis is used to solve complex problems by looking at both the unstabilized control section shown in the upper left in the stabilized section in the upper right, and how they can change under cyclical loadings. The analysis uses partial differential equations to determine the results. The lower picture in this example, the output showing vertical sediment of subgrades of 0.5%. The use of GEOWEB confinement was effective in redistributing vertical stresses on the subgrade, resulting in larger areas of subgrade mobilization, shear strength, and reduction of plastic deformations. GEOWEB reinforcement decreased the pressure at the ballast subgrade interface by 50% for weak subgrades. GEOWEB reinforcement also increased the load bearing area of the subgrade and resulted in decreased interface pressures. Decreased pressure in the subgrade results in lower subgrade settlements. We have research summaries from the University of Kansas, Dr. Yi Han, including the smart rock testing in Oregon State, led by Dr. Ben Leshinsky, if you're interested. The research summaries provide a complete description of the testing on the testing and the impressive results. Just to start off, I'd like to provide a brief overview of some track problems. GEOWEB stabilization can be used in all rail applications. In mainline track, high stress areas such as bridge abutments, grade crossings, diamond crossings, other areas subject to routine maintenance. The system is very flexible, and as stated, we provide free designs for all of your project, no matter the size. So I'll discuss some rail applications. This project was solved a couple of years ago, very typical one for us. The track was experiencing some settlement issues that were leading to quite a bit of maintenance and tamping. The engineer contacted us and we evaluated the situation and provided a free evaluation, including cross sections and calculations. You can see here the existing track has been removed and placed to the side. An excavator is being used to remove the buildup and the base to proper elevation. You can see just the contractor working subgrade to the appropriate grade. You can see the contractor has excavated subgrade and is now bringing the GEOWEB geotextile for installation. This is an up-close view of the contractor connecting the two GEOWEB panels together with the AccraKey connection device. For a small project, this is an acceptable method for connecting the GEOWEB panels together, but for larger project, we recommend staging tables. Here you can see the use of staging tables where JSON panels can be connected together prior to being expanded and placed across the prepared subgrade. For rail applications, we typically use two panels wide, with each panel having an area of about 230 square feet, giving you a total square footage of 660 square feet. Presto has a significant amount of installation experience, and we, our distributor, will be on site to support the contractor with tips for quick and efficient installation methods. So basically, after the panels are connected on the staging tables, they're transferred for installation. Typical installation rates are 3,000 square feet per hour with a crew of three. This facility here was a 25-acre intermodal yard in Seattle, and due to the size, the contractor had multiple crews working at the same time. Or you can get creative ways to keep the panels open. It's a rail project we did in Poland. You can see how they got a little carried away on the number of wood stakes, but even this method works to keep the panels open. Here you can see up close picture of the geotextile being installed under the geob. You know, two panels of the geob, phenomenal width. Like I said, 16 feet. Geotextiles typically come in widths of 15 or 17 feet. So the panels can actually be over or under expanded to meet the appropriate geotextile width. Here you can see the contractor placing the infill material as geob panels are expanded down the track. Once all the geob panels are expanded, the excavator spreads the material out and prepares it for compacting. On this project, they brought in a smooth drum roller to compact the material. It should be noted that vibratory compaction is typically not required, and rolling is more than adequate. If you over-vibrate the infill, you can actually raise the geob panels. So you want to be careful, just lightly roll it, or just light vibration, or just roll it. And you can see the finished installation. Here's another typical problem that we get contact on a weekly basis. A very small section of track has high groundwater, low subgrade strength, maintenance and tamping is required regularly, and they have tried other solutions with a lack of success. Here you can see they have excavated the area for installation of the geob in an enhanced woven geotextile. An advantage using geob is that it can be installed in any weather conditions and wet subgrades. No special installation methods are required. Here you can see a close-up of the enhanced woven geotextile layer and the geob panels being installed. Very important note on geotextiles, we never ever recommend the use of slip tape wovens for any geob installation. Slip tape wovens do not allow drainage, and poor pressure can build up, which can lead to global failure of the cross-section. You should always use either enhanced woven or a non-woven geotextile. The actual geotextile that is selected will be based on the subgrade type, and we will assist you with the selection during the evaluation process. Improper geotextile selection can lead to issues down the road, so it's a very important part of the recommendation. The recent AREMA manual that came out also does not allow for slip tape wovens being under track. And once again, the final installation. I can't remind you enough the importance of selecting appropriate geotextile to ensure a successful long-term project. Here's a project we completed in Northwestern Canada. The subgrade is extremely poor, with subgrade CVRs of 1% and less. Once again, the railroad is having to spend a significant amount of time and money maintaining this section. Lots of issues with ballast contamination. Here you can see all the bad pumping on this section. The track, you see a lot of the fines that came up through the track, through the ballast. Just a video showing when the train goes by, you can see the track depression. Since the subgrade was so poor, with a CVR less than one, we recommended factory sewing of the enhanced woven geotextile. In accordance with ASHTO M288, a minimum 3-foot overlap is required for 1% CVR. And sewing is typically recommended when the CVRs drop below 1%. Factory sewing is recommended for this project to ensure long-term success. And here you can see TEP 2 15-foot geotextiles with the factory seam right down the center. You can see insulation of the geob. It's a very remote area in Canada, so not a very easy location to get to. Contract putting a track and the ties for the finish installation. You can see the geotextile and geob, I'll just cover up the final ballast just on the corners. And the final ballast placement. This is a project in St. James, Louisiana. It was for a food manufacturing plant. The track needed to cross a sugarcane field. It included 1 mile of track. As you can see, the subgrade, very low CBRs, less than 1%, and extremely high groundwater levels. We worked with the engineer and provided a design which incorporated a layer of Tenkata RS580i, enhanced woven geotextile, 6 inches of subballast above the geotextile, and then a 6-inch geopanel. Due to the track poor subgrade strength, design revealed that a 12-inch subbase was required under the geopanels. After backfill and compaction, the geotextile was wrapped over the panels to provide a burrito type encasement. The wrap ensured that we did not lose any of the subbase into the poor subgrade soils around the stabilized cross section. The burrito approach has been used on hundreds of installations with low subgrade strengths with great success. Here's a mainline track project in Brazil for heavy haul coal with the subgrade strengths. On this one, weren't too bad, 1 to 3%. Consisted about 10 miles of track, had decent subgrade, but the ballast become fouled, and track required ongoing maintenance. We worked with the engineer, provided a design which included, once again, enhanced woven geotextile. Here you can install them. You can see them installing the panels over the geotextile. The panels go in very quickly with the use of the atrophy connection device. Once again, two panels side by side down the track. This was actually a 17 and a half foot wide geotextile. Very interesting point of this project is sometimes we can reuse the salvage ballast for infill. You can see the salvage ballast being stockpiled next to the rail here. So you can imagine how much cost savings can be achieved on projects using salvage or even contaminated ballast. As stated earlier, this project was 10 miles track with 6-inch GEOWEB. They saved bringing over 16,000 cubic yards of material. So not only did they save a lot of money, they saved a lot of time. So the track was in service much quicker than if material had to be hauled to the site. Here you can see the salvage ballast being compacted in place and the finished installation. We do a lot of rail track all over the world. This is a project consisting of 5 miles of new track for network rail over in the United Kingdom. This project was located on their northern hub. Soil strength was not that bad, about 3% CBR, but they had lots of pockets of bad soils that were having issues with differential settlement. So the settlement issues were leading to a significant amount of ballast tamping and maintenance. So we work with network rail, provide a cross section consisting of a 12 ounce non-woven geotextile and 6 inches of geo. Another part of this project is we installed sensors under the track to measure the settlement reduction and did a corresponding laboratory test to develop a design standard and confirm that what we found out at the University of Kansas. Here you can see the laboratory test that was completed at TU Klostow in Germany. Once again, it was very similar to the testing we did at University of Kansas, typical box test with repeated loads with varying subgrade strengths, cycles, and CVRs. Here you can see the outputs from the finite element analysis. We had very good results similar to what we achieved at University of Kansas. Impressive results showed 50% reduction in stress reaching the subgrade, 50% reduction in settlement. So based on that study, basically 30 years of GEOWEB project under rail, Network Rail recently came out with a new design standards for using GEOWEB under track. Similar to the University of Kansas testing, we have research summaries available if you are interested. So like I said, due to the success of this project, we worked with Network Rail to determine and develop the GEOCELL design method that is now in place. As discussed, the infill is very flexible. We can use recycled materials or even coarse sand. Sand has been used on numerous rail and intermodal port projects. Here's an interesting project we did for the port of Panama. During excavation, the contractor encountered a large area of petroleum contaminated soil. Contaminated soil can be seen in the picture on the left here, the very dark sand. The options were very limited, as you can imagine, and removal and off-site treatment and disposal costs would have been significant. Land was actually acquired through the military, so we had a little bit of flexibility in on-site treatment. So we worked with the authorities to just stack the contaminated soil, and we turned it over and over to remove some of the pollutants. Since GEOWEB can confine and stabilize sand, we actually used the site-treated sand for a portion of the port and a portion of the rail. So it saves a significant amount of time and money. High stress areas subject to maintenance, bridge abutments. As we all know, bridge abutments are high stress areas when you transition from a solid structure to a prepared subgrade. You hear it all the time, the bump at the end of the bridge. This class one uses GEOWEB at a lot of their new bridges to control differential settlement and long-term settlement to eliminate that bump at the end of the bridge. Here's a project we recently did in Texas. There are different types of installation methods that we can use at the bridge abutment. On this project, we use one layer of GEOWEB and enhanced woven geotextile. Typically, we use two panels in width, which provides, once again, a a width of about 17 feet and two panels in length, which provides a length of about 44 feet. So you can see it here, 17 feet wide and two panels in length, 44 feet in length. Two panels length really leads to an acceptable reservoir stress distribution off the bridge, depending on the amount of settlement that is expected. Sometimes we actually provide two panels stacked on top of each at the bridge abutment and then transition to a single geoblayer that we can work to determine the most applicable layout for your project. So depending on the depth of this bridge abutment, that's when we sometimes use two layers at the bridge GEOWEB interface and then transition to just one single layer after 27 feet. Still 44 feet of transition area, but two layers for the first 27 feet and then one layer for the remaining 27 feet. This is an abutment on Florida East Coast Railroad. This is adjacent to the Fort Lauderdale Airport. Very high maintenance area for many years due to the heavy impact loads from rail cars transitioning off a concrete bridge abutment onto concrete ties. Basically they're getting a lot of moisture build up on this one too. So we work with Florida East Coast, prepared to design using once again a hyper enhanced woven geotextile, a 6-inch sub ballast, and 6-inch geo panels. You can see the panels in the base in this picture. On this project, they elected to use just one layer of GEOWEB. Here you can see the GEOWEB panels being filled with 3/4-inch crushed aggregate and ready for compaction prior to adding the ballast layer. On this project, we not only stabilized the bridge abutment, but also extended the GEOWEB panels through the grade crossing. Grade crossing was a very routine, heavy maintenance area due to the soft soils and all the heavy trucks going into the airport. So this crossing received a very, like I said, a significant amount of loads and weight since it is the main access to the airport. You can see the maintenance being done just with a drum roller. And here you can see the final grade crossing. Florida East Coast stated that the area with GEOWEB stabilization was subjected to over 25 million gross tons in the first year with no deflection. The other end of the bridge without GEOWEB settled over 2 inches and had to be resurfaced in 2 years. Crossings. We deal with a lot of high stress areas. Once again, grade crossings are one of them. So I wanted to share a couple interesting projects here. This is a grade crossing in Cozy, Texas. The existing crossing consisted of standard reinforced concrete panels and wood ties. The crossing is located adjacent to a concrete plant and the heavy trucks were damaging the crossing. The system prematurely failed due to excessive braking and acceleration forces being transferred to the crossing to the subgrade below. The concrete panels did not hold their position despite being lagged to the ties and tack welded to each other. Several panels failed completely and had to be placed and patched with asphalt. The railroad came to us and presto designed a cross section union GEOWEB, once again enhanced woven geotextile to dissipate the forces from the traffic and rail while providing basically a floating system absorbed the lateral braking and acceleration forces. As you can see, GEOWEB is placed once again two sections out from the crossing, underneath the rail and extended on both sides. This project was also interesting because they actually used a recycled composite grade crossing along with composite ties. Here you can see the composite crossing and then the enhanced woven geotextile and GEOWEB panels being extended out into the roadway. Here you can see the first train to the grade crossing prior to even finishing the GEOWEB infill. Since replacement in 2016, there has been zero settlement or deformation of the roadway or track structure due to loading and braking. Most of the crossings that we do are done overnight to reduce downtime. It can be finished very quickly. Typically, 4 to 6 hours, depending on the size. The crossings are typically taken down, late Saturday night, around midnight, and back in operation on early Sunday morning. Unlike with asphalt crossings, we need to have the plant open. GEOWEB crossings are flexible and can be scheduled to limit track downtime in times with less traffic to fit your schedule. Here you see the GEOWEB panels being filled with ballast rock. Once again, enhanced woven geotextile, 6-inch GEOWEB panels. Typical ballast being installed. The ties and rail being installed. Like I said, typical crossing installed under 6 hours. So speed of installation, lack of track downtime is, as we all know, significant. Tower 55 is an aggregate crossing in Fort Worth, intersection of Fort Worth. One of the busiest crossings in the country, actually. Great crossing services Union Pacific, BNSF, and actual local passenger trains. Over 100 trains use this crossing every single day. And due to this high volume, trains had to come to a complete stop and had to be staged in sidings a mile away. So the Tower 55's track and signaling was set up to restrict train speeds, and delays could be up to 90 minutes per train. So due to the importance of this intersection, the class ones wanted to make sure the crossing had no issues with settlement or maintenance. And the GEOWEB approach, along with the geotextile, was added to this project. Once again, we worked closely with the engineer to provide this design. You can see, once again, nighttime instruction. No special equipment is needed to install the GEOWEB panels. Once again, they did staging tables here for the install and just brought multiple sections together to connect them. You can see the enhanced woven geotextile. Once again, after the crossing was all set, GEOWEB was backfilled. Displacement of their ties, rails. Here's slide shows the accurate intersection prior to completion. And here's the first train going through the complete intersection. Project has been a huge success, reducing train delays, and no maintenance issues and settlement or deformation have occurred since the track went into operation. We also do a lot of special track work. One good example is scales. Scales require a very stable subgrade for accurate measurements. We'll work closely with the scale manufacturers to develop the cross section required for installation. Once again, here you can see another approach. This one was a 4,800 pounds per foot woven geotextile, enhanced woven geotextile, 6 inches of geo. The subgrade here was pretty low. So we put about a foot of material over the top of this one. And here you can see the infill just being dumped on top. Like I said, we brought this about a foot of materials placed over the top of the GEOWEB. Here you can see scale installed prior to the final ballast placement. And the final ballast in place with the first train coming across the scales. For all of our projects, regardless of the size, we provide a free design evaluation, including calculations, cross sections, specifications, real application. The design is based off the REMA manual, the Talbot method, and our research and testing. We actually look at four limiting design limitations, including maximum flexural stress in the rail, the maximum seat load, the pressure on the ballast. We want to make sure that the pressure on the ballast is kept below 65 psi or 85 psi for high quality ballast. And also, we want to keep the track depression under 1/4 inch. Here you can see what a typical cross section looks like. Once again, we'll provide a full solution, including the type of geotextile separation layer, whether that's a non-woven or an enhanced woven geotextiles. Most of our applications are in low subgrade CBRs, silty soils, so most of the time we're going to be using an enhanced woven geotextile. We try to stay away from the non-woven geotextiles for high silt, low plastic clay applications. Since non-wovens are 3D in nature, fines can actually get up inside that 3D system and clog the geotextile, which could lead to pore pressure buildup. Enhanced woven geotextiles provide separation, filtration, and reinforcement in our planer, so they keep the fines from getting up and contaminating the ballast. So in summary, GEOWEB can be added to the rail project to provide a more stable and longer lasting ballast, which will reduce maintenance and repairs. The ability to use low quality aggregate, sand, or even salvage ballast can save a significant amount of money and time. Also, The ability to reduce the stress on a subgrade when control differential settlement, it can potentially reduce subgrade ballast thickness, leading to additional cost savings. Our research and testing at the University of Kansas, TTCCI, and the UK proved that we can significantly reduce ballast movement and rotation, not only in the geopaddles, but also control ballast movement below the tie and above the geopaddles. Controlling movement and rotation of the ballast reduce tamping, maintenance, and long-term costs. Once again, we provide free designs for all of our projects and recommend a complete solution. The GEOWEB system has been solving the most difficult settlement maintenance areas under rail for over 40 years with great success. We have a very detailed project website at www.prestogeo.com with many tools available for your projects. We have quick links for information from design through construction. We also have a link to our YouTube channel, which has lots of installation videos and quick videos for load support, channels, slopes, walls, and rail. Our installation tab here has dropped down for complete installation packages with all the resources combined into one package. So if you go to our website, you click on the request for project evaluation. Oops, sorry about that. Here's a free project evaluation. It'll bring this this tab. You basically just go to load support and rail. You fill out the form and send that to us. That'll come into our design team. There's also an option where you can attach files such as drawing geotech reports to the submittal. Also, if you want to just discuss the project, you don't have all the information, you can always just give us a call or send in an email. One of the biggest questions we get is about costs, and there's no surprise there, especially if this is a new technology for you, you've never used GEOWEB. Having an idea of how much the GEOWEB system can cost compared with other stabilization techniques is very important. So we do have a basic comparison for the GEOWEB system for a load support application. In this case, a gravel surface road. The comparison shows the difference in both price and cross-section depth for an aggregate only, unreinforced section, a section using geogrids and geotextiles, and then two sections showing the use of a GEOWEB system, one with aggregate and one with salvaged on-site materials as a fill. You can see the GEOWEB system is both thinner and less expensive than the other methods. So if you can imagine, if on-site material is utilized, you can save a lot of money. In fact, a 40% savings can be realized compared to the geogrid geotextile section, which does not allow for the use of most salvaged or on-site materials. Of course, your aggregate costs, distance to the quarries may vary, but this will give you a general idea of the savings that can be achieved. And one part of our evaluation process is we will provide a full cost analysis for you that you can use to compare against the other sections. We'll work with our distribution network to provide that cost to you for all your projects. We have made it faster and easier for you to obtain your PDH certificates with our webinar dashboard on our website. Under the Learning tab, you can easily view all of the library of webinars and download PDH certificates for on-demand webinars. So your webinar dashboard will keep a record of on-demand webinars completed along with PDH credits earned. Please note that the certificates for live webinars like today's are managed separately from on-demand webinars dashboard. So you won't find your certificate from there today and there, but you will receive an email from GoToWebinar in the next 24 hours containing a download link to obtain your PDH certificate. In 2 to 3 days, you will also receive a separate email from Presto with more information about accessing the on-demand webinar dashboard with other helpful resources. If you do not receive these emails, please check your spam folder. So with that, I'd like to thank you for attending today's webinar. I appreciate your time. Once again, please remember, we offer free evaluations, plans, calcs, specs. We will be hosting more webcasts in the future, so certainly be watching for them on information on dates. We are also getting back out on the road. I'm doing presentations live. So if you're interested in that, you can give us a call and we can set something up. So with that, if you have any questions, we can take a look at those. So once again, you'll get that final email soon, contact detail and link. So once again, thanks for your time and really appreciate all of your effort. One question is on the geotextiles. Yes, There's a big difference between non-wovens and woven geotextiles, especially when it's a high clay, low plasticity material. If you look, talk to the geotextile manufacturers, they consider a non-woven geotextile clogged or failed if the silt content is higher than 15% and the plasticity level is lower than 3. So we got to be very careful when specing non-woven geotextiles. And you know, the woven geotextiles, like I said, give you the strength, they give you filtration, and they give you drainage and reinforcement. So as far as the GEOWEB thickness, typically under rail, it's going to be a 6-inch. Our mid-size cell, which is about 30V6, is typically used. On some of the low-speed rails, we have used 4-inch, but typically it's always going to be typically a 6-inch rail and a 6-inch GEOWEB. In the design calculation, someone asked about the design calculation. Just going back here. There's a lot of inputs in here. What we do is we input the car weight. We input the type of rail, you know, the weight of the rail, the inertia, the modulus, the type of tie, whether that's concrete, wood, or plastic, the tie dimensions, the tie spacing. We enter the agreement of factor of safety, CBR, and your ballast depth, and we run our calculation, which gives us the whether we need a non-woven or woven geotextile, and whether we need a base underneath the geo and above the geotextile. All right, it doesn't look like there's any more questions, so I really appreciate everyone's time today. Hope you have a good day, and hope you can come back and visit us on some more Presto webinars or reach for an on-site webinar. Thank you very much.